Disclaimer, to anyone who suffers from motion sickness, please be warned, my autofocus was having a field day, so if you still really want to learn about Bowlby, close your eyes and listen to the audio. Thanks, bye! Hello, today we're going to be discussing the theories of John Bowlby. John Bowlby was a psychologist during the latter half of the 20th century. His full title, according to Wikipedia, is Edward John Mostyn Bowlby, CBE, FRCP, FRCP Psych. He was born on the 26th of February 1907 in London, and he died on the 2nd of September 1990 on the Isle of Skye, at the ripe old age of 83. Bowlby theorised that mental health and behavioural problems all stemmed from childhood. Bowlby was influenced by Lorenz's study of imprinting, 1935, which in summary is this episode of Tom and Jerry. Minus the murder part. Lorenz showed that attachment was innate, at least in ducklings, and therefore has a survival value. Bowlby believed that an infant's attachment to their mother was innate. He suggested that during evolution, it would have been the babies who stayed close to their mother who would have survived. This means, through natural selection, infants are biologically programmed with innate behaviours that ensure an attachment occurs. Therefore, he hypothesised both infants and mothers have evolved a biological need to stay in contact with each other. Babies are born with the tendency to display certain innate behaviours, called social releases, which help ensure proximity and contact with the mother or attachment figure. For example, smiling, crying, crawling, etc. These are species-specific behaviours. These attachment behaviours form a fixed action pattern where the infant produces social releases, such as crying, which stimulate caregiving from adults. The element of attachment is therefore not food, but care and responsiveness. Although Bowlby did not rule out the possibility of other attachment figures for a child, he did believe that there should be a primary bond, which was much more important than any other. In Bowlby's eyes, this was the mother. Bowlby argued that the relationship with the mother is somehow different altogether from any other relationships. This is known as Bowlby's monotropic theory of attachment. He believed attachments may develop in a hierarchy below this. An infant may therefore have a primary monotropy attachment to its mother, and below her, the hierarchy of attachments may include its father, its siblings, or its grandparents, etc. Essentially, Bowlby suggested that the nature of monotropy meant that a failure to initiate or a breakdown of the maternal attachment would lead to serious negative consequences, possibly including affectionless psychopathy. Bowlby's theory of monotropy led to the formulation of his maternal deprivation hypothesis. Bowlby used the term maternal deprivation to refer to the separation or loss of the mother as well as a failure to develop an attachment. Bowlby, 1951, claimed that mothering has a critical period. It is in this period where he suggested attachment must form. He suggested that mothering was almost useless if delayed till after the first 2 years of life. The underlying assumption of Bowlby's maternal deprivation hypothesis is that continual disruption of the attachment between infant and mother within the critical period of 2 years could result in long-term cognitive, social, and emotional difficulties for that infant. He believed this risk continued until the age of five. The long-term consequences for maternal deprivation might include the following: delinquency, reduced intelligence, increased aggression, depression, affectionless psychopathy. According to Bowlby, affectionless psychopathy is a condition involving a lack of emotional development, characterized by a lack of concern for others, a lack of guilt, and an inability to form meaningful and lasting relationships. In 1944, Bowlby conducted a study which he named the 44 Thieves Study. This study was to test his theories regarding the relationship between the infant and its mother during the first 5 years of life being most crucial to socialization, and that disruption of this primary relationship could lead to a higher incidence of juvenile delinquency, emotional difficulties, and antisocial behavior. To test these hypotheses, he studied 44 adolescent juvenile delinquents in a child guidance clinic. Between 1936 and 1939, an opportunity sample of 88 children was selected from the clinic where Bowlby worked. Of these, 44 were juvenile thieves that had been referred to him because of stealing. Bowlby selected another group of 44 children to act as controls. These individuals were referred to the clinic because of emotional problems but had not yet committed any crimes. On arrival at the clinic, each child had their IQ tested by a psychologist, who also assessed the child's emotional attitudes towards the test. At the same time, a social worker interviewed a parent to record details of the child's early life, for example, periods of separation. The psychologist and social worker made separate reports. Bowlby then conducted an initial interview with the child and accompanying parent. He found more than half of the juvenile thieves had been separated from their mothers for longer than 6 months during the first 5 years. In the control group, only two had had such a separation. He also found 14 of the young thieves showed affectionless psychopathy, whereas none of the control group did. Bowlby found that 86% of the affectionless psychopaths in group 1 had experienced a long period of maternal separation before the age of 5. Only 17% of the thieves not diagnosed as affectionless psychopaths had experienced maternal separation, and only 2 of the control group had experienced a prolonged separation in their first 5 years. Bowlby concluded that maternal separation / deprivation in the child's early life caused permanent emotional damage. He diagnosed this as a condition and called it affectionless psychopathy. As well as the long-term effects of separation from the mother, Bowlby also looked into the short-term effects. During 1952, Bowlby was working alongside James Robertson. They believed that short-term separation from an attachment figure leads to distress, and they called this the PDD model. Bowlby and Robertson observed children who experienced intense distress when separated from their mothers. Even when such children were fed by other caregivers, this did not diminish the child's anxiety. They found 3 progressive stages of distress. Protest. The child cries, screams, and protests angrily when the parent leaves. They will try to cling on to the parent to stop them from leaving. Despair. The child's protesting begins to stop and they appear to be calmer, although still upset. The child refuses others' attempts for comfort and often seems withdrawn and uninterested in anything. Detachment. If separation continues, the child will start to engage with other people again. They will reject the caregiver on their return and show strong signs of anger. These findings contradicted the dominant theory of attachment at the time by Donald and Miller. They took a behaviourist approach rather than Bowlby, who took an evolutionary approach. Donald and Miller seemed to underestimate the child's bond with their mother. The behavioural theory of attachment stated that the child became attached to their mother because she is the one who feeds the infant. In 1969, Bowlby suggested that the child's attachment relationship with their primary caregiver leads to the development of an internal working model. In 1999, Bretherton and Munholland defined an internal working model as a cognitive framework comprising mental representations for understanding the world, self, and others. A person's interactions with others is guided by memories and expectations from their internal model. According to Bowlby, the primary caregiver acts as a prototype for future relationships via the internal working model. Around the age of 3, these expectations seem to become part of a child's personality and thus affects their understanding of the world and future interactions with others. In summary, John Bowlby had an evolutionary / biological approach to attachment. His theory of monotropy meant that a baby's attachment to its mother is innate and more significant than any other relationship. A failure to gain this bond or a breakdown of this bond would lead to maternal deprivation. Maternal deprivation can cause affectionless psychopathy, which means a lack of guilt and an inability to form meaningful and lasting relationships. This links in to Bowlby's theory of an internal working model. This theory sees the bond between the mother or primary caregiver and the child as the main example in the child's mind of the world, how to treat future relationships, and of themselves. In my next video, I'm going to be discussing the positive and negative evaluation points of the 44 Thieves Study and the implications that Bowlby's theories have had specifically on the British education system and the early years system. For all my coursework essaying people out there, check the description for the transcript of this video and references. Thank you for watching. Bye!